Namaste. The pranayama is also a very important aspect for you to improve the immune system. How to do the different pranayama at home? What all the pranayama we can do to strengthen your immune system and the respiratory system, that we will see today. So the lungs activation for the respiratory system to activate, the pranayama which is very useful is the Bastriga pranayama. Bastriga pranayama. Before that, if you can do a kriya practice, that is the kapalabhati kriya, that is not the pranayama but a preparatory stage, initial preparatory stage for the pranayama, we can do this kriya technique, that is kapalabhati practice, forceful exhalation, kapalam bhati, to shine the brain, it is very useful. So that circulatory system activate, the respiratory system activate, and the digestive system activate by doing kapalabhati. How we can do, we will see. You can use your hands in the Surya Mudra or Vayu Mudra or the Chin Mudra. Any mudra, we can keep your hands and then forcefully, actively, you have to keep exhaling. Each stroke is to be counted mentally also. 120 strokes, if you can do, that is the best way. There is no facial changes. Facially, don't need to squeeze for each time. That is not necessary. Very relaxed the face. Preferably, Vajrasana and Padmasana is the best posture for doing the practice. So, how we can do is fold your legs and sit comfortably in Vajrasana, so that the spine will become erect and Vajra Nadi will get activated. So you can use your hands in Vayu Mudra or any mudra which is comfortable and do forcefully exhale. And each time when you do exhalation, flap your abdomen also. One-twenty strokes per minute is ideal. So slowly you can increase the duration. Beginning time 40, 60, 80 strokes we can do, 100 strokes. So like that 1 minute, 120 times, 120 strokes, 120 exhalation. That is active exhalation and passive inhalation. After each exhalation, naturally the inhalation will happen. That no need to do forcefully. So active exhalation only we have to do is both the nostrils together. Other one is with the Nasika Mudra we can do alternate nostrils exhalation. That also we just see. That active exhalation we can do. You can keep your palm on the stomach also and do active exhalation. So the pressing end will activate the digestive system, Samana Vayu get activated, and pressing will stimulate the digestive system, and the flapping will increase the vital energy also. So that way it can be done. Even when you're doing both the nostrils together, both the palms also we can keep on the stomach and do the forceful exhalation. This way you can do Kapalabhati as much time we can do it. Preferably 120 strokes. Single nostril also we can do forceful exhalation. So one nostril you do as much time you can, then you do other nostril forcefully exhale. This is one way of other way of doing the Kapalabhati. Then other way is deeply inhale, then exhale with the different intervals. This way also we can do Surya Bheda Kapalabhati, Chandra Bheda Kapalabhati also we can do. Inhale through the right nostril and forcefully exhale through the left we can do. Another is Chandra Bheda Kapalabhati, inhale through the left, exhale forcefully through the right. This way also we can do Kapalabhati. So most popular is both the nostril Kapalabhati and the alternating nostril Kapalabhati. This we can do as a preparatory stage for pranayama. So after that we can do some sectional breathing, abdominal breathing, thoracic breathing, clavicular breathing, and full yogic breathing. Abdominal breathing, you have to keep your hands in Chin Mudra and do deeply inhale, bunch your stomach. Exhale, sink the abdomen. Focus on the breathing and do very slow and steady breathing without any sound. We have to do this pranayama practice. The next breathing, this we can do minimum of 5 times we can do. Next breathing is Chinmay Mudra. All the fingers we have to lock except the thumb and index finger. Keep it on the middle of the thighs. And inhale and expand the chest. Gently exhale and contract the chest. Inhale, expand the chest. You feel yourself, the breathing and the expansion of the heart, lungs region. The middle of the lungs activate. Inhale. Exhale. Slow and steadily breathe. Abdominal breathing activate the lower part of the lungs. This is middle part, the upper part through the thoracic and the clavicular breathing. Third type of breathing. Make fist of your hand. Adi Mudra it is called. Keep it on the waist region. Inhale and raise the shoulder up. Without holding the breath, slowly exhale from it. Inhale, raise up. Exhale from it. So Adi Mudra we can do the clavicular breathing. Next one is all the three together. Full yogic breathing we can do by keeping the hands in the Brahma Mudra. Mushti. Make fist of your hands up. Keep it on the lap, on front of your body. And then do the deep inhalation. Inhale and raise the shoulder up. Expand the chest up. The same time, bulge your stomach as much you can. And hold breath. Minimum of 2 seconds. Or maximum or whatever capacity you can. 5 counts, 10 counts you can do, or 21 counts of holding the breath under Kumbhaka you can do, then slowly you have to exhale. The shoulder rotation happens. Inhalation time, raise the shoulder from front side, hold it, then slowly exhale with a relaxed face. It is to be repeated. Full yogic breathing, Purna yogic shwasana. Inhale, exhale. This is to be done, Adhama, Madhyama, like that, Adhya, Madhyama, those Shwasana Kriyas, this also to be practiced. You can keep your hands like this also, we can do for the Adhya, this, we can keep your hands like this, or folding the hands, and this way also, you can do the full yogic breathing. This is also very useful for activating the, all the three lobes of the lungs. The next practice is the Bastrika Pranayama. Forceful inhalation, exhalation. Active breathing, active inhalation and exhalation. So forcefully inhale and exhale with the both the noses. How we can do, you just see. Active breathing. So extends under can do very fast also. So forceful breathing is one of the best practice for your lungs, to activate the lungs, best exercise. So best exercise we can do for the lungs is the Bastrika Pranayama. By raising the hands also, we can do Bastrika Pranayama. Inhalation up, exhalation down. Make sure that elbows are touching the side of the ribs, so that the lungs also get activated, strengthened. So utter strokes possible. Preferably some 21 rounds, 21 strokes per each time you can do, some 4 times we can do. This Bastrika Pranayama, mellow breathing, is also very useful for the lungs to activate. So alternative nostrils also we can do, means a single nostril also. So close the right nostril, raise the left hand up. Same way, opposite nostril also we can do. This practice alternative we can do, both the nostrils we can do, by raising the hands up we can do. So this way, forceful inhalation, exhalation. In Kapalabhati we have seen that only exhalation is happening. Here, inhalation and exhale, Puraka and Rejaka is happening in the Bastrika Pranayama. Another one which we can do practice is the right nostril breathing. You have to close your left nostril and inhale, exhale only through the right nostril. That is also very useful for increasing the heat and activating the lungs region. Inhale, exhale only through the right nostril. With 1:2 ratio, whatever time you are using, double the time you can use it for exhalation, that is very good. Another practice is Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama. The starting from the left nostril, exhale through the left nostril. Inhale through the left nostril, close the left, exhale through the right nostril, then inhale through the right nostril, then exhale through the left nostril. That is one round of Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama. First inhale through the left, Exhale through the right, inhale through the right, exhale through the left. That minimum of 9 rounds if you can do Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama. No need to hold the breath without any mumbaga. More time devoting for exhalation if you can do. We can chant mentally any mantra, omkara, soham, sound also we can produce. Means mentally you can chant.